Hello students, welcome to the class on Economic Survey Volume 1 Chapter 7. Now this chapter is about the fiscal capacity of India. This chapter is about what is the fiscal strength of India. Now before I discuss about this chapter, it is important to understand the meaning of fiscal capacity. What is meant by fiscal capacity? And then I will be discussing about what are the main things discussed underneath this chapter. Now, fiscal capacity means that how much revenue is generated by the government and how much expenditure is done by the government. So fiscal capacity primarily has to do with the quantitative aspect ki kitna sarkar paisa ikattha kar sakti hai aur kitna sarkar paisa kharch kar rahi hai. So this is what is primarily meant by fiscal capacity. Now in this chapter in economic survey, the government has dealt with the fiscal capacity from the various dimensions. Now the first dimension by which they have analyzed the fiscal capacity is the prima facie comparative dimension. Now what is meant by this prima facie comparative dimension? They have actually compared the numbers of how much is the tax collection per GDP. Tax collection per GDP of our country. And then they have compared about the direct taxes share with respect to GDP. Then they have compared with the expenditure per GDP. So these things have been compared in this chapter, and this comparison is done in a comparative manner. Comparative means with different countries we have compared the India's fiscal capacity to generate the revenue and India's fiscal capacity to do the expenditure. Now by comparing, doing the comparative analysis, we get to know about the strength, the Indian fiscal revenue collection strength and Indian fiscal expenditure strength. So this is the first thing that has been done in this chapter. And the second aspect that has been focused in this chapter is about the comparative analysis about these figures, but along with that taking into consideration the economic development of our country. Now in economic development of the country, the factor of per capita income has been taken into consideration. The second analysis kiya gaya hai chapter mein, isme bataya gaya hai ki just जितना हम रेवेन्यू कलेक्ट करते हैं या जितना हम स्पेंडिंग करते हैं वो तो ठीक है, वो कम है कि ज्यादा है किसके पर्सपेक्टिव में देखा गया है? देश की आर्थिक स्थिति के पर्सपेक्टिव में. दैट हैज बीन एनालाइज्ड, दैट हैज बीन व्यूड फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ द इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट ऑफ अवर कंट्री. एंड द थर्ड एनालिसिस दैट हैज बीन डन इज अबाउट दीज थिंग्स, अबाउट द फिस्कल कैपेसिटी, the revenue that the government is earning, the expenditure the government is doing, the ratio of the direct taxes vis-a-vis the GDP of the country, but from the perspective of democracy. From the perspective of democracy. And along with this, the government has also discussed an issue about the accountability, the fiscal participation of the citizens and democracy. So this is a question that can be asked in public administration this year. Then the fourth thing that has been discussed in this chapter is about the fiscal participation of the citizens vis-a-vis the political participation of the people. Now, when it comes to the total tax collection in India, it is about 17% of the GDP. Now, what is meant by 17% of the GDP? Now, tentatively, I will give you a tentative figure about the Indian GDP. Indian GDP is about one crore economy. So the total productivity of the Indian economy is of 1 crore. Now, what is meant by 1 crore economy? Now, 1 crore economy means that we are producing the goods of worth this price, 1 crore. And out of that, how much is the tax collection? It is 17%. So total tax collection 17 lakh crore rupee hamara tax collection hota hai Hindustan mein. And in this total tax collection, the amount, the direct taxes, the people jo log pay karte hain direct taxes, it is just 5%. So in India, we have a very less number of people who are paying the direct taxes. Direct taxes participation in India is very, very low. And this is one of the reasons why India has not been able to do more expenditure, because there are fiscal deficit constraints. Itna hi lagbhag sarkar kharcha karti jitna hamara tax collection hai, iske aas paas hi hamara expenditure hota hai. So government of India on a yearly basis spends around 17 lakh to 18 lakh crore rupees every year. Now, judging from the first perspective, prima facie perspective, if we do the comparative analysis of India vis-a-vis other countries like United States of America, of the European countries or of the developed countries, there the tax collection, it ranges in the ratio of 25 to 30%. Agar itna hi GDP France ka hota to 30 lakh crore rupaya ikattha kar lete ek saal mein. But Hindustan mein kitna paisa revenue sarkar ikattha kar pati taxes se, total taxes se 17 lakh crore rupaye. And out of this, direct tax collection is just 5% of the GDP. So, prima facie, it seems that India is an outlier. We are outlier in this phenomena. Now, what is meant by outlier? Outlier means, hume aur bahut zyada improvement karni hai. Hamara aur deshon ke saath bahut bada gap hai. Developed countries बहुत अच्छा tax collection कर पा रहे हैं और उनकी spending भी ज़्यादा है. हिंदुस्तान में हम बहुत पीछे हैं अगर हम prima facie ये comparison करते हैं. But अगर हम ये comparison एक अलग perspective से करते हैं, from the perspective of economic development, we get altogether a different picture. And this picture conveys that India is not an outlier, rather India is very close to the countries, to the Western countries, to the developed world, when we take into consideration the size of the GDP along with the economic development of our country, when we take into consideration the per capita income of the people in our country, then the amount that we are collecting via direct taxes, amount we are collecting via indirect taxes, the amount we are spending on health, the amount we are spending on social infrastructure, it is almost in consonance with what all is spent in the Western world. So judging from a different perspective, we get altogether a different picture. इससे हम ये नहीं कह सकते कि हिंदुस्तान का रेवेन्यू जनरेशन कम है जब हम इस प्रस्पेक्टिव से देखते हैं. किस प्रस्पेक्टिव से? फ्रॉम द प्रस्पेक्टिव ऑफ इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट. ऊपर से देखोगे तो आपको लगेगा बहुत बड़ा डिफरेंस है. जब आप इकोनॉमिक प्रस्पेक्टिव से देखते हो तो आपको लगता है कि डिफरेंस इतना ज्यादा नहीं है. Now there is a third way to view this fiscal capacity thing, to entire this fiscal realm thing. The third is with respect to democracy. And in this perspective, we are not only taking democracy, but we are also taking the per capita income of our democracy, like the size of the Indian economy, the political participation of the people. Now this perspective again tells that the revenue collection and the direct taxes payment vis-a-vis GDP, with respect to GDP, is again in consonance with the parameters, with the Western world standards. उनके स्टैंडर्ड के हिसाब से हमारा बिल्कुल सही है. बट वी आर स्पेंडिंग लेस ऑन हेल्थ एंड एजुकेशन व्हेन वी टेक इनटू कंसिडरेशन द डेमोक्रेसी एस्पेक्ट, द पॉलिटिकल पार्टिसिपेशन एस्पेक्ट. जब डेमोक्रेसी को हम कंसिडरेशन में लेते हैं, डेमोक्रेसी एज अ फैक्टर, जब इस फैक्टर से जज किया जाता है फिस्कल कैपेसिटी को, तो कहते हैं पता लगता है कि फिस्कल कैपेसिटी हिंदुस्तान की बिल्कुल सही है. जितना पैसा टैक्स कलेक्शन हो रहा है 17 लाख करोड़ रुपीस, इट इज ऑल राइट. बट वी आर स्पेंडिंग लेस ऑन हेल्थ एंड वी आर स्पेंडिंग लेस ऑन एजुकेशन इन कंपैरिजन टू द स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ द वेस्टर्न कंट्रीज. देन द फोर्थ परस्पेक्टिव from which the entire fiscal situation is judged is the perspective of the democracy, the perspective of people's participation. Now, when it comes to people participation, what is meant by people participation? People participation means number of people who are voting, number of people who are eligible voters. अगर एलिजिबल वोटर्स का कंपैरिजन करें रेशियो का, विज़ द पीपल हु आर पेइंग द डायरेक्ट टैक्सेस, नॉट द इनडायरेक्ट टैक्सेस, द डायरेक्ट टैक्सेस, क्या पता चलता है? सो द रेशियो इज जस्ट इन द रेंज ऑफ 4-5. सो वी हैव वेरी लेस नंबर ऑफ पीपल हु आर पेइंग द डायरेक्ट टैक्सेस. And this year's economic survey has highlighted that this ratio needs to be increased to 23%. Vote करने तो बहुत लोग जाते हैं हिंदुस्तान में, but tax pay करने बहुत कम जाता है. जब इस ratio को किया जाता है तो answer is just 4-5%. So we need to enhance this ratio to 23%. This will help in increasing the revenue that our country is earning. Now, there is another perspective to judge about the fiscal situation in India. Only 15.5% of the people are in the tax net. 85% of the economy is out of the tax net. Now, we also need to compare India with China. Now, when you take the case of China, they don't change the tax limits now and then. But changing the tax limits now and then is a very peculiar case of India. In India, we tend to fluctuate the tax limits now and then. In every budget, we tend to revise the limits of the tax. Now, had the tax limit been just 1.50 lakh, we would have been able to add about 30,000 plus crore rupees more to the tax kitty. It would have been in the range of 17.5 lakh crore rupees. But due to the populist measures, due to the political reasons, we actually tend to revise the tax limit every year. We actually tend to increase the tax limit every year. Now this is again what is causing the problem to the fiscal situation in India. Now, a very important aspect that needs to be analyzed is people's accountability, people's level of participation in administration vis-a-vis the tax that they are paying. जब लोग ज्यादा टैक्स पे करते हैं उस सिचुएशन में डायरेक्ट टैक्सेस का बात कर रहा हूं मैं जब लोग डायरेक्ट टैक्सेस पे करते हैं वो सरकार से जवाब भी मांगते हैं जवाबदेही बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ जाती है अकाउंटेबिलिटी सरकार की बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ जाती है कंट्रोल बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ जाता है बट वी डोंट विटनेस दिस फिनोमेना इन इंडिया नो व्हाई वी डोंट विटनेस The exact accountability by the people. The reason is because the number of direct taxpayers in India are very less. So if we want to create a robust democracy, robust accountability, vibrant accountability, vibrant democracy, we need to enhance the tax base, direct tax base. And how can that be done? That can be done if we will not tinker with the base tax limits now and then. We will be able to have more people in the tax kitty and that will help in strengthening the fiscal capacity of a country like India. That will help in enhancing the tax to the GDP ratio. That will help in enhancing the direct tax to the GDP ratio. That will help in enhancing expenditure to the GDP ratio. That will help in enhancing the health expenditure to the GDP ratio. That will help in enhancing education expenditure to the GDP ratio. Now all these ratios need to move up. Now for a country like India, which is housing about 125 crore plus people, we need to provide them with the basic facilities like education, like health, infrastructure, roads, electricity, housing, sanitation, water, etc., etc. Now these can be provided only if the fiscal capacity of the country will be strong. Now at the level of economic development of what we are, the fiscal capacity is actually right. But in the years to come, in 2020, 2030, when the GDP will be rising, when the productivity of the nation will be going up, it will be swinging up, we will also require to see an upward swing with respect to the tax collections and specifically with respect to the direct tax collections. So this was all for this chapter. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you are interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to view the information of the classes that we are offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and briniki.com. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. And do download that brain map that I have made with respect to this chapter. And how you need to go about these chapters. First of all, just watch this my classes. After watching their classes, read the chapter. After reading the chapter, read the brain map. And in that brain map, after reading and watching this, just add few more things. So, and just revise that again and again. So that will help you in your mains examination. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.